So in today's video, I'd like to introduce you to some scammers who originally claimed to be from Visa or MasterCard fraud department, and then they pretended to be from my bank. And I want to highlight some of the tactics that these guys use, because I don't necessarily want to say that they're being clever, but given the amount of scammers I speak to, they even had me wondering.
So this is a very suspicious payment activity in your account because they are purchasing on a Bitcoin behalf of you. That's why you receive this call, okay? To verify it, like this is you or not.
Okay, well it's not me.
Yeah, okay. So if you did not authorize this payment, then I can guide you how to cancel this payment, okay? And I'm helping you to cancel this payment, and after cancellation, no money has taken out of your account. Understand, sir?
Yeah.
Okay, so right now, sir, can I speak to Mr.
Yeah.
Is it you? Okay, and there was a register number which is ending with, is it your number?
Yeah.
Okay, so just tell me one thing, did you remember, when did you last time use your card, any online purchase or any physical transaction? Yeah, did you remember, when did you use it?
Today. I used it this morning.
Today. So, is it a physical one or is it an online transaction?
It's a physical one.
Okay, is it a physical transaction? Okay. So, is it which bank card you use today? Is it a physical transaction?
Yeah, it's my Bank of Queensland card.
Okay, so not an issue, sir. Right now, I'm just providing you the reference number. And you just note down the reference number, okay?
Okay, and can you tell me where were you calling from again?
Yes, we are calling you from Visa and MasterCard Security Department.
Okay.
Yeah. So right now, I'm going to connect to the cancellation department, okay?
All right, and how much was the charge?
So first of all, I'm just providing you, sorry?
Can you tell me how much the charge was?
It's $900, it's $900 for purchasing on a Bitcoin.
And yeah, okay, for the Bitcoin, all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, can we get that fixed up, please? Because that sounds a bit...
Yes, sir. Right now, I'm helping you to cancel this payment. That's what I'm telling you, okay? And when I'm providing you the reference number for the transaction, okay?
Yeah.
Do one thing, just to have a pen or piece of paper, I'm providing you the reference ID number.
Okay.
So just bear with me, sir, a second. Very shortly, we'll be going to connect it to the Queensland Cancellation Department, okay?
Yeah.
Thanks for calling BOQ. Please note, your call will be recorded for coaching purposes. Any advice given is of a general nature only and does not take into account your personal circumstances and may not be suitable for you. You should seek your own financial advice before making any decisions.
Thank you for holding the line. This is Andrew from Bank of Queensland. How may I help you today?
Hi, Andrew. How are you going?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. I'm not quite sure. I had someone from Visa Fraud Department sent me to you. They said I have a Bitcoin charge of $900 that's not my purchase or something. I'm not quite sure.
Do you have any reference number or transaction ID with you?
Yeah.
I see that your card has used this morning for a purchase of a Bitcoin of $900. And this transaction is going to overseas to Ryan Miller in New Zealand. Do you know this person any chance?
No, I've never heard of him.
And anyone else who used your card on your behalf to make this transaction to him?
No, no one's using my card.
Like no family member or friend who have the access of your details?
No.
Right? Because since I see they have tried your card to use three transactions this morning. One is for the cryptocurrency, which is again an international transaction, right? Two in the Kohl's store for a purchase of a gift card. Like, did you purchase any gift card this morning?
No. No.
Because they have swiped your card for these three transactions and all regarding the same amount, $900, right? So this is where we just found this dodgy and the call was given to you to just get the confirmation whether this transaction was done by you or not.
No, it wasn't by me. I don't know who's doing that, but that's not got anything to do with me.
Definitely, I will go ahead and help you to cancel that out. So right now what I'm just doing, I'm putting this transaction on hold, okay, because it's already been charged on your account. So we will just put this transaction on hold and it will revise to your account. In meantime, could you just help me? Recently, did you use your card for any physical payment, like any petrol station or grocery store?
Yeah.
This morning when you have used your card, did you use your card to make a tap payment or you swiped your card?
I tapped it.
tapped it, right?
And always tap it, only unless it's a bigger one. I'll just have to look on my bank, I'll just see.
Sorry, come again?
I'll just have to look on my bank, I'll see when the last purchase I did.
Okay, because see, right now what I can see, because since you have been not aware about all these transactions, right? Definitely then someone has been trying to hack into your details where they have used your information to make this purchase. I can even find an email address. I will just confirm you that. Tell me, are you still active on this email?
No.
Okay. And that was used by you earlier or someone else has been created this fake account for you?
I don't know. I don't remember that address at all, mate.
Okay. So you don't even recognize this email address? Because this email address is used for the purchase of those 900 crypto this morning. Okay. While this Hotmail account. Now, what I can just do at the moment, I can guide you, first of all, to report about this incident to the cybersecurity team of Australia. So later on, whatever the misuse which has done to your details, you are not the responsible for it from here onwards. Okay?
Okay.
So right now, can you just put me on a speaker and could you be able to access Google on your phone?
I know how to put you on speaker, but I don't know how to do the Google thing, mate. It's a little tiny phone, a little flip phone. I don't know how to do that stuff on the phone, mate.
Tiny means like it's a QWERTY keypad or it's a touch screen?
It's got numbers on it, mate.
Okay, so it's like a QWERTY keypad. You can't able to access the internet on it, if I'm not
wrong. I don't know, it just makes calls, mate.
Which device you generally use to make the shopping or to make any payments?
I do that on my computer.
Could you just able to walk down in front of your computer and switch it on if it's off?
Yeah, I've got it on. I'm just looking at my bank here. Did you want to know? The last transaction I did was a couple of days ago.
Okay. And since just see, is there any transaction which is you finding up a dodgy which you think you haven't did it, but it still shows that in your account?
Well, it doesn't show today's ones yet, because they're probably the weekend. Because everything was shut yesterday. Imagine the bank's still closed today normally.
That's right. Till Monday, bank is closed, right? Only you can talk to the assistant technical support 24/7, because we work even in the weekdays and public holidays as well, right? So right now, if you're on the computer, as I would just like to first of all help you to report about this problem, right? So you can go ahead, you can report it. Same time, we can help you to get your transaction cancelled. All right? So are you on the Google now?
Google Chrome.
Now, once you're on Google Chrome, right, type, it's AC, A for America, C for Charlie, S for Sugar, C for Charlie, space, Australia.
Okay.
And give a click on search.
Yeah.
Now, what is the first option which you can see?
cyber.gov.au.
That's correct. That's right. If you see scrolling down the page, you got a second or maybe I think third one, which says Cyber Security Team Australia or Cyber Security Center. And you got the official site like cyber.gov.in. Can you see that?
Do you want me to click on this? homecybergov.au?
That's correct. That's the official site.
Okay.
And once you open that, what do you see now?
It says Australian Signals Directory, steps for organizations to protect their IT environments, protect your charity or non-profit from cyber threats.
Scroll down the page a bit.
Yeah.
While you scroll down the page, you see an option on the top called report.
Yeah.
While you scroll down, you got an option on the top in the middle called report. So click on that report option.
Okay.
Now once you click on report, what you have got?
Report a cybercrime incident or vulnerability.
That's correct. Now scroll down the page. You will get an option called whom you want to report on behalf, like an individual, business, or a government.
Yeah.
Can you see that? So as in it's an individual, click on an individual.
Okay.
And as once you click that, your request is submitted, right? So within the next 24 hours, you will get a confirmation email from them related to all the inquiries, what they have been tracked, right? They will give you information about that. Now, I will just request you, if you can come out of this page.
Okay, so if you've got to this point and you're still wondering if this is a scam, then I'm glad you saw this, because these guys spent about half an hour on the phone with me trying to gain trust. They're pretending to be from my bank. They have information about me, which, as I suspect, is quite possibly from an Optus breach, given that the email address that they had, and I've been an Optus customer for quite some time, I suspect that's where they got their information from. Now, don't be mistaken, these guys installed multiple remote access tools onto my computer, including AnyDesk and UltraViewer.
Hi. Now, what I will just do, I will quickly help you to connect you to the Queensland Bank Security, where we can update the things and we can cancel the transaction as well. Okay. Type over there www.A for Alpha, N for November, Y as in Yankee, D for Delta, E for Echo, S for Sugar, K for Kilogram.com. Yeah, she is from the fraudulent team of Visa Master who have connected you to the bank. Because their duty is to see the unauthorized transaction. And when they find any unauthorized transaction, they connect the bank and they work. We work on that. Okay? Okay, so that's what you're telling, that you have sold that and you have no use of it anymore. Correct?
And once they had access to my computer, they attempted to change my password and also tried to steal $20,000 out of my account through two separate accounts, which of course were both reported.
Look on your screen, Drew. It is asking for your password to verify. Can you put that in?
No, I'm not changing my password, mate. It says don't share this code with anyone.
Yes, open that message and read out the code, which you got that.
It says don't share it with anyone, mate.
So just type the code in, or you can tell me, I can put it for you.
But I'm not going to include the rest of the call in this, because I wanted to bring to attention the tactics that they use to gain trust. And even when I was talking to them, I had moments when I was unsure of what they were doing. And I believe that the tactics that these guys are using can possibly fool a lot of people. So if you like this video, hit the like button down below, share it around on your social networks, let people know of the tactics that these guys are using. I'm hesitant to call them clever, because if you wake up in the morning and decide to be a scammer, there's nothing clever about that. Make sure you subscribe if you want to see more. You can also become a member down below. You'll get early access to videos like this one. And thanks for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.